Welcome again in my YouTube channel. Today I'm going talking about circulatory system. So please subscribe my channel, like my video, comment and share. Human circulatory system is made up of three components that are heart, blood vessels and blood. So we may define circulatory system as movement of blood from the heart toward the body tissues and return back to the heart through the blood vessels. Since heart is also called cardiac and the blood vessels are called vasculars, so sometimes this system is known as cardiovascular system. Okay, let us check each component of cardiovascular system. Number one, heart. This is a hollow muscular organ which is situated in the middle of mediastinum in the thorax. This means that it is located between the two lungs and immediately above the diaphragm. The weight of human heart is about 300 grams in male and 250 grams in female. The main function of the heart is to pumping the blood into the body tissues through the blood vessels. Human heart consists of the four chambers that are right atrium, left atrium, right ventricle and left ventricle. Left ventricle contains more muscles than others since it is the one which pumping the blood throughout the body except in the lungs. According to those four chambers, heart divided into two-sided. The first one is right side of the heart. This receives deoxygenated blood from the body tissues and pump it to the lungs so as to be oxygenated. This kind of circulation is called pulmonary circulation. The second one is left side of the heart. This receives oxygenated blood from the lungs and pump it to the body tissues. This kind of circulation is called systemic circulation. Okay, let us looking on the valves of the heart. As there is four chambers in the heart, also there is four valves. The first one is tricuspid valve. This allows blood from the right atrium to the right ventricle. The second one is bicuspid valve, sometimes known as mitral valve. This allows blood from the left atrium to the left ventricle. In one way, these two valves are called atrioventricular valve. The third one is aortic valve. This allows blood from the left ventricle to the aorta and then to the body tissues. The fourth one is pulmonic valve. This allows blood from the right ventricle to the pulmonary artery and then to the lungs. In one word, aortic valve and pulmonic valve are called semilunar valve. These valves are one-way direction so as to avoid backward flow of the blood in the heart and the other body tissues. Then, closing of these four valves lead to the sound that produced by the heart known as doop-doop. Okay, let us look on the second component of the cardiovascular system, which is blood vessel. Blood vessel, this is a tube or pipe-like structure in which the blood is moving within it from the heart to the body tissue and back to the heart. There are two major types of blood vessel in human body. The first one is arteries. These are those blood vessels that carries blood away from the heart toward the body tissues. According to this, all arteries carry blood under high pressure. They all carry oxygenated blood except that of pulmonary artery. This is the reason why most of them they look red in color. The second one is veins. These are those blood vessels that carries blood back to the heart from the body tissue. According to this, all veins carry blood under low pressure. They all carry deoxygenated blood except that of pulmonary vein. This is the reason why most of them they look blue in color. Okay, let us look on the other types of blood vessels. There is three sub blood vessels. The first one is arterioles. These are very small branches of arteries and are the one that supply blood to the tissue from the major arteries. The second one is venules. These are those that collect blood from various organs and tissue and unite to form veins. The third one is capillaries. These are the thin-walled vessels that connected the arterioles and venules. And this is a place where exchange of nutrients and the waste material between the blood and the body tissue take place. Okay, for today I would like to end here, but for the coming video I'll prepare the last component of cardiovascular system, which is blood. So please don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share so as to get the new update.